Welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will teach you how to share Looker Studio reports. Hi, my name's Josh. Once your Looker Studio report is up and running, it's time to share it with the world. As you may expect, there's more than one way to share Looker Studio dashboards. In fact, I can think of at least five. How about we go through each of them? I have this Salesforce CRM dashboard that I want to share with my stakeholders. This template is a part of Coupler.io's template gallery, a collection of dozens of dashboards you can grab for free and make them yours. Have a look and see if you find something suitable for your needs. Looker Studio Access Control Center resides in the share menu on top of the screen. To invite people to your report, click either the share button or choose the respective option in the menu. The menu that pops up tells you who already has access, what's their access level, and which link settings are in place. You can invite specific users and also Google groups of users. To do so, simply type in an email address associated with a user or a group. You can choose to notify people, ticking which will trigger an email with a link to your report. At this point, you can also decide on Looker Studio permissions that will be granted to the chosen user or group. Users can be either viewers or editors. Viewer access in Looker Studio lets a user view a report. They can interact with it in a usual way, apply filters, change a date range, drill down, and so on. However, any changes they do to a dashboard won't be visible to other users. The editor access comes with the full access to the edit mode. Users can change the existing charts and add the new ones, connect more data, apply filters, and more. What's more, report editors can edit a data source and share it with others. The same for reports themselves. They can edit access for other users, except for the report owner, and take advantage of other sharing options I'll discuss shortly. If you need more details about what each role does, check the help article linked here. I'll go with viewer access for this user. Once you've got everything set up, click send, and you'll shortly see a user or a group on the list. At any point, you can update Looker Studio permissions for each added user or a group. On top of the two options I just talked about, here you can make them owners as well as revoke their access. Report owners have all the editor permissions. They can also delete a report or a data source, as well as make others owners. Be careful though, there can only be one owner. Granting someone such access will also give them the rights to remove any access to a report, yours included. You can also share Looker Studio reports via links, and there are several options available. Restricted means that only the people and groups added above can access a report. If you rely on Google Workspace across your organization like we do, you'll also see an option to share with everyone on that domain, without the need to distribute individual accesses. You can choose whether everyone should be a viewer or editor. It's worth knowing that you can combine such group permissions with individual access for specific users. For example, you want everyone in the company to view a dashboard demonstrating the key business KPIs. At the same time, one or more analysts need an editor access to maintain and keep improving a report. To achieve that, set the viewer Looker Studio permissions for everyone on your domain and add the analysts with an editor access in the usual way. The next option is unlisted, which lets anyone with a link either view or edit a report. And finally, you can set a report to be public, which will make a report searchable on Google and elsewhere. If you change the link settings, you see that changes are pending. Don't forget to click the save button, as otherwise, no changes will be applied. Another thing you could do is schedule a delivery of your Looker Studio reports. This will send an email with your report attached to your chosen contacts at a regular frequency. Add as many recipients as you need. You can customize the message that will be sent. Let's add some encouragement to check my report. What's more, you can share the whole dashboard or just individual pages. I will skip the README page, for example. And finally, choose when the first report should be sent and how frequently it should be delivered. You can further customize your delivery by applying custom filters to the data. I will choose to limit the data to only that generated this year. And let's fetch only the deals that were lost. My recipients will get a copy of a report filtered like that, while the dashboard itself will remain unchanged. Now, you can decide to send the first report right away, or save the settings, and the deliveries will follow the schedule you previously set. If you open this menu again, you'll see on the schedule if any is set. There can only be one at a time, so if you wish to change it, click the Edit Schedule button or delete it and start anew. When emails are sent, they will look like this. They will feature a link to the live dashboard and a custom message if you set any. Below, you'll see the embedded report and a PDF version if you prefer. By the way, if you're new to Looker Studio or want to brush up on your knowledge, we've recently released an extensive Getting Started tutorial for this Google's platform. You'll find a link in the corner of your screen. Another option you can use to share Looker Studio dashboards is with a link. A link you can copy from here is different from the one available via the Invite People menu, because it features all the selections you've made on the dashboards, custom date range, specific selections or drill downs, and so on. If you want to show the very specific data to your recipients without forcing them to do all the clicking, use this option. The next option lets you embed a report on your website. Make sure the first checkbox is enabled. You can grab the iframe code, adjusting the width and height of the embed below or directly in the code. Or if your site requires just a URL, use the second option. The last option lets you download a report as a PDF. You can fetch all pages or only some. Some additional options are also available. And here's what a Looker Studio dashboard looks like when downloaded as a PDF. To the left, you'll see the list of pages, and you can quickly jump from one to another. And that's it. Now you know how to share Looker Studio dashboards, but if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.